And I mean, it's not something that you can just see with the naked eye. Of course, you have to, again, do a lot of screening and tests, to see it. Okay, then. So, and we talked about an aspect of polycystic ovarian syndrome and endometriosis, of course, being really, really big topics. And of course, one of the things that affect so many women out there. But then again, what brings about the difference? Because sometimes someone might confuse, PCOS for endometriosis. So can we just talk about some of the differences of the same?
Well, looking at the differences, if you look at polycystic ovary, is literally some level of hormone imbalance. You can put it like that.
Yeah.
But for endometriosis, which is also another probably difficult thing to detect and is detected quite late,
yeah,
is a scenario whereby normally the menses will come out in the normal way. But this is a condition whereby some of the periods of menses, which are supposed to come out, we call them the stroma, they go back to the body and they start accumulating in the pelvis. They have other things in common, like for instance, fertility, both polycystic and endometriosis will still give you the same picture. Yeah, but for endometriosis, then the problems you are looking at over time is issue of discomfort in terms of pain, and all that. Even during normal intercourse, there could be pain sometimes. In advanced stages, there could be problems of even urine, blood in the urine, even in the stool, because it depends on the stage. Yeah. So the same thing applies early detection.
Okay.
Yeah, because once it's detected quite early, then
interventions could be made
yes,
towards
yes,
the same.
Yes,
All right.
exactly.
Okay. So then, in terms of what causes it, I know we talked about there's no specific cause for the same, and then this is not just a single, let's say condition that you can just pinpoint and say, here, this is it, and this is what causes it. So can we talk about some of them, the risk factors, or some of the things that put a woman at risk of developing PCOS? Or is it that all women develop it at some point?
Well, I think looking at it, everything or most of the diseases as we speak now, you'll find they have some hereditary kind of. Yeah. So there could be also a family, strong family history of the same.
Okay.
Yeah. And that's why initially when we started, I told you can have women who are very slim and they have polycystic. So you are,
ovarian syndrome. Yeah.
Yes, they don't have necessarily to be obese. Yeah. But then there could be a family factor. So a strong family factor, that's important to check. And other things is literally things like lifestyle. Yeah, because when you talk of obesity, then lifestyle becomes one of the major issues. Yeah, most of these women you'll find, or ladies, you'll find they're quite obese. And especially with obesity around the abdomen, abdominal area. Yeah, so this already brings about problems in their metabolism even. You'll find they have issues like what you call insulin resistance, or sometimes even they're given medicines to try and put the, insulin levels
balance
so that, because they will also have a risk of getting diabetes. What we call type 2 diabetes, that's diabetes of the adult.
Yeah.
Yeah, so all those risk factors are there.
Okay.
Okay. And by the time they have these cycles which are not ovulating, then their womb is also at risk of things like cancer in future.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why early detection and treatment is really
very
important.
Very important.
Yes.
Okay.